Good morning, Professor. We are from Wong Shiu Secondary School. Today, we are presenting on the topic triples of sum of two squares. In 1903, there is a question posed on Educational Times is to find all the consecutive triples of sums of two squares. And in 2000, a prelim exam had a similar question. Little have raised a related problem. Given distinct positive integers h and k, do there exist infinitely many triples n, n plus h, and n plus k that are all simultaneous sum of two squares? For convenience, we will define n, n plus h, and n plus k as hk triples if all of them are sum of two squares. Then the prelim problem is to prove that there exist infinitely many 1-2 triples. Then we use Excel to generate 1-2 triples. We prove that all the starting number of the 1-2 triples must be a multiples of 8 and is congruent to 0, 8, or 16, mod 72. And we also find that there are many pairs of 1-2 triples with their starting numbers differ by 8. We call this kind of triples as consecutive 1-2 triples. We provide new proof of the existence of infinitely many consecutive 1-2 triples. Take n equals 2a squared, then n plus 2 and n plus 8 are obviously sum of 2 squared. If b squared minus 2a squared equals 9, then n plus 9 and n plus 10 are also sum of 2 squared. And n plus 1 equals 4a over 3 squared plus b over 3 squared. Since both a and b are multiples of 3, and there are infinitely many solutions to b squared minus 2a squared equals 9, therefore, there exist infinitely many consecutive 1-2 triples. For the triple consecutive 1-2 triples, we don't know whether there is infinitely many of it, but we prove that the starting number must be a multiples of 576. Then we will consider some special cases of 1-2 triples. For the cases with the starting number x squared minus 2, in this case, x squared will congruent to 2 mod 8, which is impossible. Therefore, this kind of triples do not exist. Then, for the middle number being a perfect square, the problem is whether x squared minus 1 can be expressed into sum of 2 squared. If x squared minus 1 equals y squared plus z squared, since a perfect square can only congruent to 0 or 1 mod 4, therefore, y and z are even, and x is odd. Now, we take an arbitrary even number set. Let z squared plus 1 equals a times b. Let x equals a plus b over 2, and y equals a minus b over 2. Then x and y are both integers, and x squared minus 1 will equals y squared plus z squared. This gives a method for us to construct all the 1-2 triples with the middle number being a perfect square. Then we will consider the starting number of the triples is x squared. The problem is whether x squared plus 2 can be expressed into sum of 2 squared. From our computation, if x squared plus 2 equals b squared plus c squared, we observe that there are only some possible values of x minus c, including negative 1, 1, 7, 17, or 23, etc. Let c equals x minus l. We then claim that x squared plus 2 equals b squared plus x minus l squared has integral solution if and only if all the prime factors of l are congruent to plus or minus 1 mod 8. It can be easily proved that L cannot be an even number. If L is even, then B squared congruent to 2 mod 4, which is impossible. Therefore, L is odd. For example, we take L equals 5. We find that B squared will congruent to 2 mod 5. Therefore, it is impossible, as 2 is a quadratic long residue of 5. For convenience, we will use Lasson symbol. Lasson symbol A over P equals 1. If A is a quadratic residue of P, A over P equals negative 1. If A is a quadratic long residue of P. Here is some properties of Lasson symbol, and we want to know that for what L, 2 is a quadratic residue of L. Express L in prime factorization. It is trivial that 2 over L equals 1 will imply 2 over PI to the power mu I equals 1 for all I. For this statement, it can be the converse can be proved by Chinese remainder theorem. And we can also see that 2 over p to the power mu equals 1 will imply 2 over p equals 1. For this statement, the converse can be proved by induction. And by the second supplement to the law of quadratic reciprocity, 2 over p equals 1 if and only if p is congruent to plus or minus 1 mod 8. Therefore, a squared plus 2 equals a minus l squared plus b squared has integral solution if and only if all the prime factors of L are in the form of hk plus 1 minus 1. Now we turn on to a particular case of Littles' problem. If n and h are both perfect squares, we only need to consider n plus k. Let n equals a squared. And we define fl equals 1 if the equation have integral solutions. Otherwise, we define fl equals 0. Since fl equals f negative l, therefore we consider positive l's only. And let l1, l2 to ln be pairwise coprime integers. We have fli equals 1 for all I if and only if f the product of li equals 1. This can be proved by Chinese remainder theorem. And we want to know that if p is a prime, for what integers alpha we will have p, we will have f p to the power alpha equals 1. Then we let p to the power lambda be the highest power of p such that it defies k. We find that the possible values of alpha depends on two factors. First, whether lambda is odd or even. Second, the value of kp, that is k over p to the power lambda. For p equals 2 and lambda is odd, the upper limit of lambda of alpha is lambda minus 1. If lambda is even, it depends on the remainder of k2 divided by 8. For p greater than 3, or prime, if lambda is odd, then the upper limit of alpha is lambda. If lambda is even, it depends on whether kp is a quadratic residue of p. When given k, the value of l can be determined. The general solution ab depends on the square root of k mod l, let it be theta, and we will have this general solution. For example, we take negative 180 as k. Then for p equals to 2, since lambda is even and k2 is congruent to 3 mod 4, therefore alpha is at most 2. For p equals 5, at p equals 3, k3 is a quadratic residue of 3 and lambda is even. Therefore, alpha can be any non-negative integers. For p equals 5, since lambda is odd, therefore alpha is at most lambda, that is 1. For p greater than 5, it depends on the Lasson symbol k over p. It equals negative 1 over p times p over 5. By considering different cases mod 5, we can conclude that p is a quadratic residue of 5 if and only if p is congruent to plus or minus 1 mod 5. And we know that negative 1 is a quadratic residue of p if and only if p is congruent to 1 mod 4. Therefore, by Chinese remainder theorem, we can have the condition of L. Here is all the possible values of L. And here shows some values of L and the corresponding theta and the corresponding solution A and B. Here is two more examples of K and the corresponding values of L. Recently, we found an article including three solutions to the 1903 Educational Times problem. However, none of these solutions can give a complete set of all 1-2 triples, and we modify one of the words from the article. Since n is divisible by 8, it can be written as the sum of square of two even numbers. Therefore, n plus 1 and n plus 2 can be expressed in this way. From the equation, we can see that both a and b are of opposite parity, and both c and d are odd. For example, we take a, b, c, d equals 8, negative 3, 5, and negative 1, respectively. And there will be a corresponding 1-2 triples, 144, 145, and 146. However, this method will give many non-integral solutions. For example, we take another a, d minus b, c. In this case, the corresponding x and y is not an integers. We concluded that all 1-2 triples will correspond to sets of a, b, c, d. However, many long solutions are given. Therefore, we want to find the condition on a, b, c, d such that it gives 1-2 triples only. We didn't find the condition yet, but we have a theorem and a conjecture. We have a, d minus b, c must congruent to plus or minus 1 mod 6, and the conjecture is based on our computation. We think that for an integer s which is congruent plus or minus 1 mod 6, there will be a corresponding ad minus bc equal to s and the corresponding abcdsy, and sets of 1-2 triples are corresponding to it. This is the end of our presentation. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.